The following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
It's Varsity Week on Sale of the Century, and our contestants will win a large screen TV, a pair of motor scooters, and a mini boat. One of them will win the grand prize, this fabulous Jeep, and a trip to the Summer Olympics in Seoul, Korea. It's Varsity Week on Sale of the Century. And now here's the star of the show, Jim Perry.
Hello there. Thank you. Thank you very much. Happy to have you with us. Good to have you with us, and a great day to join us as Varsity Week is coming to a close. And today, one of our young players guaranteed is going to win a trip for two to the Summer Olympics and that beautiful Jeep. So a big day. Let's get to it. Summer Bartholomew will introduce the players.
Yes, hi.
This should be fun.
He competes in three sports from Los Angeles, California. Welcome, Jonah Boris.
Hello, Jonah.
And she plays center position in basketball. Come and see the California for Chance together for Marnie Riley.
Hi, Marnie.
Thank you,
and he's been a volleyball player for 2 years from Palos Verdes, California. The to Mark Edler.
Hello there, Mark. See you later with some
volleyball. Thank you. Let's get acquainted. Jonah, your sport, what, swim team, polo, diving?
Yes. That's right, Jim. I've been on the varsity swim team, water polo team, and diving team for 4 years, and it's just been great.
Good. Well, now it's on to college, right?
On to college.
Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Marnie, your sport is basketball, huh?
Absolutely, Jim. I play at the Brentwood School, and I'm the center on the team, which is the natural thing for me to play since I'm the tallest on the team.
Oh, how tall are you?
I'm almost 5'11".
Oh, well, that's a perfect height for a Marnie Riley. Nice to have you here. Mark, middle blocker in volleyball, yes?
You bet, Jim. I play middle blocker for the Palos Verdes Sea Kings, and I love volleyball. It's really fun.
Delighted to have you with us as well, sir. Good luck to all three of you. One of you is going to get a chance at $5,000 with the winner's big money game. Someone's going to get a crack at $2,000 in cash. The Jeep comes later. There is a lot at stake. Good luck. Whose TV family includes kids' names Sandra, Vanessa, Theo, and Rudy? Jonah?
The Cosby Show.
Yes, indeed. $5 for the correct answer. Jonah goes for $25. Name the candy that melts in your mouth. Not in your... Mark?
M&M's.
Not in your hands. It is indeed M&M's. Mark for $25 as well. Complete this threesome. Ready, willing, and... Jonah?
Able.
You got it, and you go back into the lead by five. What percentage of something do you have if you've got half of it? Jonah?
50%.
And Jonah to 35, beating Mark to the buzzer. What nourishing vegetable can be found in the variety snap, string, lima, kidney? Jonah?
Beans.
Beans is right, and Jonah to the $40 mark. Time for News and Bargain. Player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise, and our young people have picked up a lot of good things this week. And Jonah, you've got the opportunity now to buy this.
Jonah, get hip to the latest sounds on CD with the Magnavox Compact Disc Player. Designed for outstanding sound, quality, and performance. Its memory can hold 785 of your favorite songs. Furnished by Magnavox. It's normally priced at $300. But today on Sale of the Century, it's for only $5.
CD player. The newest thing, very hot. Do you have one, Jonah?
Oh, no, I don't. I've always wanted one. I love music.
Well, that would be terrific. It's normally $300. Here, it is just $5, and I'll throw in $100 to buy some CDs for yourself. For one question, going once, gonna buy. Grab the CD, and as Greg just said, a good buy. $400 buy for the value of one question. Enjoy that, Jonah. We'll knock the five off. You're still in the lead. $10 over Mark, $15 over Marnie. The young actor who played a cocky Navy pilot known as Maverick in the movie Top Gun, Jonah?
Tom Cruise.
That's who played it, and Jonah gets that five right back. In what U.S. state could you find beaches named Pebble, Zuma, Laguna, Mark?
California.
Gotta be California. Mark to the $30 mark. Who became king when he pulled the sword Excalibur from a stone? Marnie.
Arthur.
Yes, indeed. There you go. I know you know it. You got a 25. Well, that's nice. All three players are untracked and ready to go. So it's time for the fame game. $10 money card up on the board, players. You get control of that board by identifying a famous person. I am a performer born in 1955 in Germany, where my father was an American GI. I stuttered as a child, but it vanished whenever I faced an audience. I once played harmonica with a band called Loose Goose. In high school, I was given the nickname Bruno. Still used by my... Jonah!
Bruce Springsteen.
No, that's incorrect. Out of the rest of the question, we'll clear it. Continue for Marnie and Mark. Don't say anything more. I was given the nickname Bruno, still used by my close friends.
In 1985, I was a weapons smuggler on Miami Vice, which led to an audition for a major TV show. I won out over 3,000 others for the role of David Addison on Moonlighting. Mark.
Bruce Willis.
Bruce Willis is right, but a long way. Mark gets control. $10 money card wears on.
It's behind the number two.
Lock into your buzzer, Mark. Hit that 10. You're tied, Jonah, for the lead. Good luck.
Come on, $10 money card now.
No, right up the middle, number five, and he gets.
It's an auto security system. MaxiGuard Black Max Auto Security System, featuring the Maxi Shocker motion detector designed to provide continuous protection automatically when you leave your vehicle. Furnished by MaxiGuard.
That's $595 for the auto security system. We'll find out a little later if he gets the car to go with the security system. We'll be right back.
The bids get big.
$10,000, Bill.
$13,000.
The prizes get bigger.
A home in Florida.
On the biggest game show on TV.
Everybody ready?
The Price is Right, Saturday at 10:30.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell.
The issue is clean water. We all have a stake in it. For wildlife. For recreation.
For clean ice cubes. Clean ice cubes to chill the light, refreshing taste of a new Coke. A chilling idea.
Elect the light, better taste for a brighter, better America.
The time is now.
The taste is a light.
New possibilities. New Coke. Think about
it. 40, Mark at 30, Marnie at 25. What would you find in a jar which had a picture of Orville Redenbacher on the label? Jonah?
Popcorn.
Popcorn it is at Jonah 45. Her solo hits include Heaven is a Place on Earth. What?
Belinda Carlisle.
Just beating everyone on the buzzer. Mark is right. He goes to 35. Academically speaking, what do the initials BS stand for? Jonah.
Bachelor of Science.
Oh, I'm glad you got that right. Way to go, Jonah. You got a 50, yes. It only takes one irritating grain of sand in an oyster shell to produce, Jonah?
A pearl.
A pearl is right at Jonah to 55. Well, Jonah, you've stretched out a $20 lead now over Mark, and you can very easily afford this great prize.
Jonah, this instant bargain will really be something to tell your friends about. A fabulous ski trip to beautiful Aspen, Colorado. We'll fly you and two guests from Los Angeles for a five-day adventure in the Rockies. You can become your own downhill racer skiing from the world's finest slopes. Then party till dawn in the ski chalet. It's normally priced at $3,000. But today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $10.
Well, terrific. Great ski vacation. Do you ski, Jonah?
I love to ski.
Well,
it's
you
my
would
favorite
enjoy
sport.
That's a big trip. $3,000. Cost 10 if you buy it, you still have a $10 lead. If you want to hire your own stagehand to drop confetti, I'll throw in $200 in cash to go with it. You still have a lead. You got it. Enjoy that trip. Sale surprise as well, Jonah. Oh, way to go. My goodness. Oh, this feels fairly heavy. You've got a $3,000 ski trip, $200 of my money, and in addition, as a surprise, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, another $1,000 in cash. Wow. $4,200 trip for 10 bucks. Jonah, congratulations. We'll knock it off. Still in the lead, but it's a lot closer. This clergyman is the first major black American presidential candidate in history. Jonah.
Jesse Jackson.
You've got 5 of the 10 right back. Jackson it is. In what city can you visit the desolate island prison of Alcatraz? Marnie?
San Francisco.
That's the city, and Marnie to 30. Yes. Most of us would use it to open a door, but Ben Franklin tied one to his kite. Jonah.
A key.
Key is right. Jonah back to the $55 mark. In the hit sitcom Growing Pains, Mike Seaver is played by the teen heartthrob. Mark?
Kirk Cameron.
Kirk Cameron is right, and Mark to the $40 mark, yes. Well, Kirk Cameron is indeed a teen heartthrob. Alan Thicke, who plays his father on the show, said that this has greatly enhanced his romantic prospects, Alan's being on the show. He said, I have something every girl in America wants, Kirk Cameron's home phone number. We'll be right back.
Electricity flows like the very
first kiss, like a break in the clouds, and the first ray of sun, I can feel it again, something new has begun, you can tell all the pieces are starting to fit, like the first time you said, share my coke, and I knew that was it, it's an uncharted sea, an unopened door.
Money card up on the board, and this time we look for a famous thing. I am a delicacy made from roasted and ground beans. I was once used as currency by the Aztecs and Mayans. Mark.
Coffee?
Incorrect. Took a chance. Did not pay off. You stay at 40. Out of the rest of the question. We'll clear it. Continue for Jonah and Marnie. I'm now consumed worldwide at the rate of about 1 million tons a year. To make me, cocoa beans are often combined with a sweetener. I can be... Marnie.
Chocolate.
Chocolate is right. Yes, once used as currency. And Marnie, you've got control. And a $15 money card with.
It's down to number 8.
And you lock into your buzzer now, Marnie, so good luck.
Come on, $15 money card now.
No, lands on number 1, and Marnie gets...
It's a car stereo. Bullcron digital AM-FM car stereo cassette, mini equalizer amplifier, and three-way composite speakers. Furnished by Arthur Fulmer.
That's great.
Lovely prize, and you still have ample time to catch up. It is very close. Mark, you're back in now, and the three of you try this. Before he became president, Ronald Reagan was the governor of which?
California.
California, the state, Jonah the 60s. Robin Williams plays a wartime disc jockey in the movie, Marnie?
Good morning, Vietnam.
Yes, indeed. Good anticipation, Marnie the 35. What famous group of strange creatures was created by a man named Jim Henson? Jonah?
The Muppets.
Muppets is right, and Jonah the 65. Well, Jonah, that poses a little bit of a problem for you. I'll tell you, you've stretched out your lead to $25 now over Mark. $25 lead, two boxes have $100 bills, one today is worth $2,000. But it would cost you the amount of your lead if you wanted to go for it. Tough decision for you. It would cost you $25 for a shot at $2,000, Jonah. Going once, going twice. No, sir. Doesn't want to go for it. For those of you playing along at home, let's see. It was in number 3. Number 3 had the $2,000 in cash. You're giving me a look like that was the one you would have picked. That was
so.
The one he would have picked. I'm sorry I asked. Back to finish up Varsity Week and find out who our last possible winner of the car and the trip to the Olympics is right after this commercial time.
In the 21st century, a shopper will exist like no other. The Sweepinator. Only on Supermarket Sweep, today at 9:30.
No, there's a...
When I first went to Europe to ski, the only thing I could say in French or German was Coca-Cola.
There's a thirst that goes right through ya.
Looking back, it's not the winning I remember so much as the wonderful friends I made.
The taste it just can't fool ya.
Next year, the world comes to Calgary. How many more lifelong friendships will begin the same way over a Coca-Cola classic?
There's nothing like the real thing.
Christopher Hewitt plays a gentleman's gentleman to a family headed by Bob Uecker on the TV sitcom Mr. Mark.
Belvedere?
Belvedere is right. Mark to 45. In what Olympic sport would you perform a double axel, the figure eight? Marnie.
Ice skating.
Ice skating is right. Marnie to 40. Keeping it close. The Rio Grande forms most of the southern border between Mexico and Jonah.
Texas.
That's the state. And Jonah to 70, yes. Third and final fame game. All three money cards up there, including a big one worth $25. We look for a famous person. I was born in Europe in the 15th century. As a boy, I dreamed of becoming a sailor. But when I first went to sea, I almost drowned off the coast of Portugal. I went on to... Jonah.
Christopher Columbus.
That is right. Well done. With a little bit of information, Jonah. Good job. $25 money card wears on...
It's behind number 4.
Well, we lock into your buzzer with 3 money cards to shoot for. Good luck.
$25 money card now.
No, lands on number 7, and he gets...
$800.
As if you haven't gotten enough, another $800. Congratulations. Jonah's already done beautifully, and now we're going to find out who wins the match as we finish it up with a speed round. May I have 60 seconds on the clock? It is Jonah at 70, Mark at 45, Marnie at 40. A lot of questions as we start the speed round. Now, the lovely lady who turns the letters on TV's Wheel of Fortune, Mark?
Vanna White.
Right. Traditionally, what kind of fruit is used to make sweet and hard cider? Mark?
Apples.
Right. If you spend your allowance quickly, you might say money burns a hole where? Mark?
In your pocket?
Right. On TV, what incredible creature does David Banner turn into? Mark?
The Incredible Hulk.
Right. In what month do we celebrate Valentine's Day? Jonathan?
February.
Right. According to the proverb, what should you do before you leap? Jonathan?
Look.
Right. In math, what's the square root of 81? Mark?
9.
Right. On what date do we celebrate Independence Day? Jonathan?
The 4th of July.
Right. What TV sitcom features three brothers named Larry, Daryl, and Darryl? Mark?
Bob Newhart.
Yes. Which East Coast state has its capital at Annapolis? Mark?
Maryland.
Right. What is the chemical formula for water? Jonah?
H2O.
Right. Name the TV talent competition that's hosted each week by Ed McMahon. Jonah?
Star Search.
Right. According to the old saying, what kind of stone gathers no moss? Time. To an American Indian, what is a papoose? Time is up, and Jonah has won it. The last winner on Varsity Week. He got pushed for a while. Mark got to within one question of him, but Jonah came back strong to win. Back to Jonah in a moment. Won the play. Maybe a little before the time of the players. Rolling stone gathers no moss. That's the phrase. Have to say goodbye to Marnie and Mark. Delighted that neither of you are going to go home empty-handed. Marnie, you've got yourself the car stereo, the cash in front of you. You're around the $400 mark. Thank you. Good luck
with
your further studies. Appreciate you joining us. Mark, got the auto alarm with the cash in front of you. You're well over $600. We appreciate your coming as well. Good luck with your studies. Thank you for joining us. But Jonah Boris, first of all, is going to get a prize, and Jonah will call your attention to one last number left up there, and as Summer turns it over, we'll find out what it is. It is a beautiful pool table. Well, that's not bad. A great prize to be left. Jonah's already picked up a lot. Now the pool table, Don will tell him about it.
Jonah, invite a few friends over for some summer fun on a professional-sized pool table. Custom-made of solid oak with a premium imported slate top and decorated with lion claws. Furnished by Regal Manufacturing Company. This prize is worth $3,770.
Congratulations. Now Jonah tries to pick up cash playing the winner's big money game. Come on, Jonah. Well, congratulations. That was a good win because Mark really made a run at you there.
Yeah, that's pretty
close. I think on a couple of occasions, he pulled it within $5, and both times you came back strong to take the lead again. Now, you're trying for $5,000. Which envelope would you like to play, red, yellow, or blue?
Let's try blue.
All right, this blue packet you know contains those six-word puzzles. Solve four of them in 20 seconds. The $5,000 is yours. Clock starts when the first word of each puzzle is revealed, and we stop it when you hit that plunger to give me an answer. Good luck, Jonah.
Thank you.
And we'll call your attention to the words coming in up there with 20 seconds on the clock. The first puzzle starts now. Movie about killer shark.
Yes. Jaws.
Attacking beaches. Got to be Jaws. Yes. Right on target with your first correct answer. Looking for three more before that clock hits 00. Take a look at the next puzzle. Now, beauty, pageant, Atlantic City, yes?
Miss America?
Most yearly Miss America it is, yeah. But you might jump in on Atlantic. You waited for City, but you're at the halfway mark. You are a little ahead. Stay on that pace. You can't get behind now. Let's take a look at the next puzzle. Now, cowboy, hero, Tonto. Yes?
The Lone Ranger.
That's right, the Lone Ranger. Kemosabe it is, yes. 6 seconds left, three correct answers. One more, you must stop that clock before it hits 00. Jonah, good luck. We're all with you for $5,000. The next puzzle starts now. Enduring, dance, show, Dick. Yes?
Time.
Dick Clark, his American Bandstand. That's the one mistake you can make, though. You've got 1 second left. I wish if you had thought of it, you had the five. I don't know if you can do it now, but we do have, or there is time left on the clock. So we'll look at the next puzzle, and we'll start that next puzzle now. floral wreath Hawaiian visitors are giving away.
You know, I'm sure you know American Valentine. Couldn't quite think of it, but you have had a great day. You've got a great total, a lot of cash, the trip, the ski trip, and now Jonah joins our other four winners, and one of them is going to get a trip for two to the Summer Olympics in this beautiful Jeep right after this commercial timeout. Congratulations.
Waiting.
It's a splash in the heat of day, a shiver that's coming your way, just a sip and you're gonna say, can't fight it, no you can't hide it, feeling again from a Coca-Cola classic, you can't beat the real thing, can't beat the feeling.
is the NBC Television Network. Oh, yeah.